If you have been into forex trading for a couple of months now, you must have already seen traders sharing their trading setups with lots of screens or crazy indicators and stuff. I have myself seen traders sitting in front of 5 to 10 different screens with using a hell lot of indicators. And I can tell with surety that most of you must have fallen for it. And why not? It looks cool and it has become a trend. And people seem to believe that the professional traders use so many screens. But honestly, that's just the opposite of what I and my fellow professional traders do. We choose to keep our trading setup as clean as possible and try to get rid of all the clutter lying around. And the reason for this is our human mind gets confused when we try to look for too many different things. Our mind is not made for multitasking. According to a study, it was found that when a person's mind focuses on one thing at a time, he or she is able to do that job easily and efficiently. The fewer things you keep your focus on, the better you will do it. And this is true with anything you do. Let it be a workout, eating, or reading. And especially in trading where a lot of emotions are involved. In trading, we try to keep a check on our emotions and control them as much as possible. And this is the reason I prefer a clean interface and I generally trade with a single screen. Look, I'm not saying you should not use two or three screens or too many indicators. If you feel that there is a need for it, then you can use it. Even I have two to three screens, but I only use it when there is actually a need for that. But 99% of the time, I trade using a single screen and a single indicator. Now, setting up your charts and keeping the interface clean is also an important part. When you first install MetaTrader, it comes with inbuilt settings and lots of tools that you don't even need. So let us go to the MetaTrader platform and I will tell you how I organize my MetaTrader platform.
The first thing to look after is the chart itself. The type of chart should be as per your own preference. Like, I prefer using candlestick charts, so I have chosen a candlestick layout. Now, your chart should look clean and clear so that you can easily read it without any distraction. For that, right-click on the chart, go to Properties, go to Show option. Now here, there are various options of the different things which you would like to have in your chart. Like, if you click on the show ticker, it will show you the name of the currency pair. If you select OHLC, it will show you the opening price, the high, the low, and the closing price of the candle. So OHLC is a short form for open, high, low, and close. The bid price and ask price will show you the bid price and the asking price offered by the broker, and it will be represented by a line, and it will be helpful for you to find out the spreads. Now, I don't need the grid and the volume lines on my chart, so I won't select it. Show trade levels will show you the level at which your trade is open, and show trade history will show you the history of your previous trades. Now, in the colors section, I like the classic black and white colors for my candlesticks as it looks clean. So I keep the borders of the candles to black and the bull candle to white and the bear candle to black. Keep the rest of the settings the same and we are done with setting up our chart. And you can see how clean and beautiful the chart looks.
The next thing is setting up the toolbar. Nobody likes it when they have to keep looking for a tool but are not able to find it because there are too many of them there. And this happens when we use the default MetaTrader settings. It comes with a lot of tools and the majority of them are just useless. So always customize the toolbar and only keep the tools that you will need during trading.
To customize the first panel, right click and go to customize. Now here only keep the tools that you need and remove everything else. The tools which I use are a new chart, to open a new chart, profiles as I have different profiles for each trading style, full screen option to full screen your chart when you need it, algo trading as I sometimes use it, new order to open a new trade. Now in the types of chart, you can either keep all the three or only one. It depends upon you. I sometimes shift to line chart for better understanding, so I kept the line chart and the candlestick option. Now moving forward, you will need to zoom in and zoom out option and tile windows option. The auto scroll chart shift, you will also need the auto scroll chart shift, the market watch list and the templates if you use different strategies. Now to customize the objects section, right click and go to customize. As I use limited tools like trendline, rectangle, Fibonacci, etc., I have only kept those to the front. And if I ever need any other object, I can go to the insert option and use it from there. The next thing is to edit the time frame section and only keep the time frame you will need.
The next important thing is setting up profiles and templates. Now, many of you may be into two different types of trading styles, like day trading and swing trading, or swing trading and scalping, etc. And also many of you may be using different kinds of strategies, which may include different indicators and different setups. So when you use a single profile for this, your chart gets messy and it has a lot of other drawbacks too. Like, I personally maintain a trading journal, and when I am trading, I draw certain setups and I don't delete it when the trade is over, because I have a habit of going through all the trades I took in a week. And so when I keep the different profiles for swing trading and different profile for day trading, I am able to learn from my previous trades by keeping the setup as it is, and the chart also looks clean. So MetaTrader has this cool option in which you can set different profiles for each of the trading styles, and you can also shift between profiles whenever you want. Now I use a different strategy for day trading and a different strategy for scalping. So I have two different templates for each one.
Like you can see, when I select day trading profile, my chart layout is changed and it has all the previous setups which I have drawn. And when I shift to scalping profile, I have a different chart layout for that, and everything is set up perfectly and it looks clean.
Now I have already told you how to set up different profiles and templates in the previous videos. If you haven't seen those videos yet, you can check it out by clicking the I button. Also, if you are new to this channel, a like and a subscribe will be amazing. Thank you.